Hey guys, so I got some ND filters. We're gonna go test those out. Like, I'd like to go to the beach, but we've got like 17 mile an hour winds right now, so I don't know about that. It's kind of strong. We'll probably just make our way over to the park and do some test footage with the ND filters and see what that looks like. Should be fun. Let's do it. Time to fly. lot of fun. I ended up coming to the beach and to go with an ND 32, just with how bright it was. ND filters hung a haunt, which I was a little worried about. Had three great flights, 16, 17 mile an hour. That's a pretty good clip. And the fastest I've flown it in so far, wind speed was about 6 mile an hour. So, you know, about 10 mile an hour faster. It's pretty good speed. I did get some warning messages about flying in high winds and to be cautious, but I was out in the open. The spark in the wind is great. I mean, it does get pushed around a little bit, but it's fairly easy to stay straight and stay on target for your footage. So, yeah, it was a great little drone in the wind. This is its highest wind speed test that I've put it in. 15, 16 mile an hour aren't gonna scare me anymore. I'm really excited to see how it turned out. So we'll see you guys at home. So just a few takeaways from the video. I definitely like the higher shutter speed footage better. For me, it was crisper than the slower shutter speed video. If I do put a filter on, I'm definitely going to use that CPL anywhere around water. I felt like the images produced from just that filter were better, and I can still film at that higher shutter speed for crisper video. So I hope you found this video helpful. If so, hit that like button and subscribe for more videos. I hope to see you guys soon.